There were 12 in all, men like Bill Dana, Milt Thompson, Pete Knight, John McKay, Joe Engle, and Bob Rushworth. They shared a common occupation, test pilot. For 9 years, these pilots flew the rocket-powered X-15 research airplane. 199 flights were made, many along the fringes of space. It was 20 years ago that the X-15, now hanging in the National Air and Space Museum in Washington, made its first research flight. NASA astronaut Joe Engle, who piloted the X-15 16 times, talked about the super-fast rocket plane.
The wings, of course, are very small. At the high velocities and high speeds that are obtained, you don't need a lot of lifting surface. And so lifting surface wings generally mean drag, and the desire was to keep the drag as low as possible. The airplane was made out of Inconel X steel. The skin was Inconel steel, which was a material that would resist heat up to about 1,200 degrees. That, incidentally, was the temperatures that the airplane had to accept at Mach 6, the aerodynamic heating at 4,000 miles an hour. Got up to 1,200 degrees. Aluminum is not able to withstand those temperatures and retain any kind of strength. So the skin of the airplane had to be steel instead of aluminum. In subsequent flights, when the airplane went even faster, even the Inconel steel had to be coated with a protective material to keep the temperatures, the surface temperature, from getting to the skin and getting hotter than what even the Inconel X could withstand. The most prominent feature probably from where we're standing is the rocket engine on the back end. It was a 60,000-pound thrust engine, liquid propelled. All the propellant was carried in the fuselage, and looking at the airplane from this angle, you can see the bubble, the cockpit bubble up toward the front end of the airplane. Just about the entire fuselage aft of the cockpit was fuel tank for propellant for the rocket engine. That propellant would burn out in 88, 89 seconds.
Traveling at speeds in excess of 4,500 miles per hour, the X-15 climbed to altitudes of over 67 miles, qualifying pilots for astronaut wings before the first man flew into space. The highly successful program returned large amounts of data about structures and heat transfer, and proved that man could fly at hypersonic speeds and adjust to control systems that are part of NASA's new space shuttle. Astronaut Joe Engle is scheduled to pilot the second shuttle orbiter into space.
The techniques and the flight control systems, the manner in which we fly, of maneuvering re-entry from space back into the atmosphere, manage the energy, terminating in a conventional landing on a lake bed now, but eventually on a runway, that technique that we're using on the space shuttle was pioneered and, in fact, very similar to the same technique that we used on the X-15 20 years ago. We've got that knowledge and know-how and the confidence to do it.
The X-15, forerunner of today's spacecraft and tomorrow's airplanes.